This is the time when we come before the Lord in an attitude of prayer. It's Communion Sunday on this Labor Day weekend, and in many ways this is like the beginning. This is like the beginning of the year. It's the beginning of the school year. It's the start of many things, and so it's good. It is good to be in the house of the Lord. We also recognize that many are away today, and while the people are away in travels or on vacation, we also pray that God's blessing will be with them. But we also pray that God will just add a very special blessing to you for being today in the house of the Lord. And I believe on this day that God has a special word for us to start our September right, in many ways to start our new year right. Amen. We need to keep, you have prayer cards in your pews. And by the way, Ed Shar has a stack right on that, a stack of blank prayer cards right on the back stand. So if you don't have a prayer card and you need one, wave your hand and we'll get you one. Alright? If you have prayer cards in your pews, if you have a special request, please take the time to fill that out. Bring them forward and we'll pray for them in Mass this morning and individually during the week. And any special requests on our hearts and on our minds this morning, especially we pray for Wayne. Been in an accident and is now in rehab, and we're just excited about that. Good things. Ted Hansen was going to have a little procedure on Friday, but unfortunately is sick and was not able to have that. We need to keep Ted in our thoughts and prayers, as well as many on our prayer list. Let's come before the Lord this morning in an attitude of prayer. We pray a special blessing upon all who are visiting with us today, Jesus. We pray that you just add a blessing in their lives. We pray for all who don't know you as their Lord and Savior, that there's a hole in our hearts that only you can fill. And Lord, that you want to walk and talk and live and breathe with each of us. And right now in the silence, Lord, we lift up to you every concern and everything that's on our mind. Just right now in the silence, we let it up before you. Lord, in your mercy, grant Almighty God that all who confess your name may be united in your truth. May we live together in your love and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy, guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, we pray especially for our president and, Lord, for the situation that is happening in Syria and in the Middle East. Lord, we pray that you would lead us and guide us into your way of justice and peace. Lord, in your mercy, give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve the Christ in them and love one another as Christ loves us. May our homes be havens of blessing and places of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. We especially pray for all whose names are on these prayer cards, those whose names are on our prayer list. And Jesus, those whose names have been mentioned out loud and those we mention to you in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, we commend your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And Lord, as we gather today and as we prepare the table, your communion table is going to come out to us this morning. And Lord, help us to just hear your word this morning. Forgive us our sins and cleanse us from our sin, Lord, and help us to live the new life that you have planned for each of us. We ask this in your name. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, it's the beginning of a new year. And in many ways, it's the beginning of a new year. And Lord, we pray for all our college students, our teachers, our students, for many that this is a week of preparation and a week of getting ready and starting new things. Lord, we also pray for our troops overseas, that all of those who are a part of us but are not here with us, that your hand would just be upon them and that you would bring them safely home. We ask this in your name. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Amen. We offer these prayers through Jesus Christ our Lord. And all God's people said,
amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.